grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge ourselves, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the innocent saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who have been pleased to gladden the world by the resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, grant, we pray, that through his mother, the Virgin Mary, we may receive the joys of everlasting life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was opened, and the Ark of his covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed loud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and in its heads were 7 diadems. Its tail swept with a third of the sun in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth, to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice from heaven say, "Now hath salvation and power come in the kingdom of God and the authority of his anointed one." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too soon in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ, the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end. When he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power, for he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for he is subjected everything under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Israel, for he has remembered his promise for me. always has the crown today? Jesus, that's right. Jesus has a crown, but a different crown. A crown of thorns. Jesus. Well, yes, he does wear a crown. A crown of thorns. But who today wears a crown? I'm speaking about this world. The world in we live in. Kings and queens. They wear crowns. Queen Elizabeth in England, she has a beautiful crown sometimes. I don't know at what time of the year she wears that beautiful crown. Wonderful. Right, so if Mary wears a crown, what is she? She is a queen. A queen. In the Old Testament, the queen was the mother of the king. That's different, you see? That's a different tradition. The queen was the mother of the king. So Jesus' mother, Mary, is a queen. All right. Now tell me, what is this? Rosary. Very good. A rosary. And what are the main prayers in the rosary? The main prayers in the rosary. The Hail Mary and the Our Father. Perfect. The Hail Mary and the Our Father. One of the mysteries of the rosary, the last one in fact, is the crowning of Mary as Queen of Heaven and Earth. So, that's important. That's an important belief, as Catholic belief. Finally, do we pray to Mary? Very good, yes, we pray to Mary, yes. We ask Mary, what do we ask Our Lady, Our Mother in Heaven? What is the main petition we ask her in here? That she pray for us. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. Now and at the hour of our death. So let us turn now to Mary, our Mother in Heaven, and the saints, and ask for their prayers of intercession as we continue this Eucharist.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Receive, Holy Father, this offering of our humility, which we bring you with joy as we commemorate the Blessed Virgin Mary, and grant, we pray, that it may be for us who are joined to the sacrifice of Christ, our consolation on earth, in our eternal salvation, which is reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Amen.
and the saints, who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say: Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my life, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the Lord be Christ, keep you safe for eternal life. Communion Antiphon. Rejoice, O Virgin Mother, for Christ has risen from